60-second review, extended review. We're going to talk about Harley Quinn, the Joker, open mind. Spoilers. Now we went back just to record that, so you're welcome. Tangled here. Can't read. You should have started the description. I didn't get everything I wanted out of these last four episodes. I did not. But we did get the feeling of Joker's lair, possibly. I mean that. Because, you know, it has some type of abandoned carnival, abandoned fair, some type of shit like that. So we did get that. And we realized he really fucked it up. Like, he really thought she would take one more and fall in love with him. So I'm going to go rob a bank. But. And then you're the Joker just be a guy. Because that was the Joker, he'd be a fucking guy. Like, let me impress him. Nobody. Nobody. Really not. She really is anybody. They made a few jokes up later. Thank you.
Take the movie. Nothing here, fucking R&D that he didn't even know fucking existed.
What the fuck is all that?
CEO of Amazon does not know what's going on in everyone's accounts. He doesn't. One third share doesn't afford you working on one of these places. He's getting treated like dog shit. Yeah, no idea. And he's never going to.
But for him to be subtly hinting that shit and knowing how in the way Bob talks to people, it's just weird. That's always weird and shit, and it's a DC thing so much. Like, I would think that by now Bruce Wayne isn't walking around Gotham having Batman-ish moments in an Armani suit. Like, the conversation. So much of my life I can't tell you.
Oh, your life must be full of secrets.
More than you know.
Like, we don't need that. Nobody would do that.
That's so weird. That's fucking comical. And not necessary. I really didn't like it. And I also feel like... I feel like his voice was way too fucking happy. We've always heard Bruce Wayne as a real kind of... First off, he's deep-voiced. No matter how you try it, there's always like kind of a ugh to his voice. Even the cartoon, it'll be like it's lighter. Hi! But it's still like, it's a heavy lightness to it. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to, to the best of my description, like there's still a, like there's an undertone to even when his voice is at a higher pitch. We didn't get that shit. Like, no disrespect to all of us. And I remember reviewing his Christmas movie, which I thoroughly enjoyed. 100% of a Lindsay Lohan shit. But Bruce, man, that's the thing. I'm gonna be. He got the job for Bruce Wayne. This is, that man was not the job you needed, though.
And then they gave him that. Why did he get the job?
It's Harley Quinn and the Joker, and we still got Batman's voice. I wanted Harley Quinn. I wanted to hear her do Harley Quinn. What was going on? Like, we still didn't get a Harley Quinn on a DC podcast yet, and we got fucked. I don't fucking understand. What was so hard about having a moment as her as Harley Quinn and her, like, do something for it? But I needed a confrontation. The only confrontation, actually, we didn't get one. But that shit between the Batman and them was not confrontational. She had a fucking plan. Well, granted, she does show a certain ability for this, understanding the criminal mind and such. And this also makes her look like she would be the plant, the brains to his crazy. But there was still no confrontation. I needed something that says, hey, I'm Harley. That just says, hey, I can break out of a prison. You're surrounded by criminal minds. You can do the fuck you want. Honestly. I don't think we needed the table being turned and that doctor coming and asking for a job. I don't need that. I get how he was the one that provided the information about the Joker, but in all honesty, that could have fucking came from anybody. The cops could have been at that event, a couple cops, and they could have been talking amongst themselves kind of loudly, and she overhears it. Like, there was so many ways. Way could have mentioned it, the other doctor could have mentioned it to her. Jeez. Like, plenty of ways they could have been. I didn't mind the Batman, the Batmobile sounds, though. It took a minute to me to be like, what the fuck is that sound? Because I only heard the word car. I was like, are they escaping in a car? Is that what that is? It's like, is the car transforming? What the fuck is this? Is this a crossover? I don't remember Joker Mobile doing all that shit. Was there a Harley Quinn Mobile? The fuck has she been driving to work? Then, of course, you know, Batman talking. What? Favorite, I don't fucking know, something, and then we hear all the shit, and you go, that must be a Batmobile. Yeah, too many sounds, way too many sounds going on there. This was supposed to be more of a less is more type of podcast, more, I felt like, introspective. But she made Batman just out there, just boom, noise. Batmobile, noise. His voice as Batman. I gotta say it. Somebody else thought it. A lot of people already thought it. No. No. That that's officially, I'm officially going to go get the works. And I like the animated shit. All of them. But there's not an animated Batman voice that I've heard, and I was like, I fucking hate this shit. What the fuck is this? I hate this shit. What the fuck is this? But my God. How did we get this? Like, I can't blame James Gunn on it. If I want to. But the voice did not work. His voice would fit more of a RoboCop remake podcast. RoboCop 2099. Yes. He's the guy you need. He's got the voice for it. Yes. Just don't let him play the original Murphy. Get somebody else's voice. Murphy's gonna sound like a fucking 12-year-old. But that's what his voice would have worked for perfectly. Super not a fan. Like, people talked about everybody's voice and Christopher Nolan. I'm going to do Batman like this. But no, his should be so
Officer Murphy! What is the matter?
I know, but man, his voice was horrible. But then there was a moment when he talked, when she called out Bruce Wayne, and his voice went octaves lower to Bruce Wayne's than went back to Batman. Like, no, guy, you can't have a car that expensive and make dumbass mistakes like that. Like, we're not doing that, sir. What do you do? You can't save Gotham
with your identity all over the place.
And yet, here we are with his identity all over the fucking place. Help me understand. Magpie made sense, because, I mean, first off, for her not to have a plan would be weird. She's a thinker. She's a doctor. Why would she not? I liked how Magpie was there. She made sense because once again, what she said, she plans. She used her resources. She's Harley Quinn. Thanks. Perfect. Just the Joker in the end. Doctor Quinn, because we never got Harley Quinn. I don't even like that I just called him Harley Quinn, because we never got a fucking Harley Quinn. This entire thing, we got stuck with Dr. Quinn and no Harley Quinn. You know what I wanted? I think fucking Harley Quinn. We never got it. And it's really disappointing. Why not? Like, it's her pocket. With the Joker's guest, because you can't have the origin without him, so that's a given.
That's what I want to know. That's what I want to know. Why did you not get that?
I think it was a big cheat. Then you want to ask her, no, it's your loot. They're calling her Doc. She's like, oh, we're going to have to find something else. Come on, we're going to get Doc. For what? I'll think of something.
End credits. No, we're not doing that shit. What the fuck is that? No, we're not doing that. No, we're not doing that.
That's garbage. What the fuck is her name? Have her make the fucking voice. Because essentially his voice grew more into the Joker as we listen. Why couldn't we get that one? It was her podcast. We just saw her go from, you know, dealing with life, meeting the Joker, manipulating the Joker, and then essentially just losing more people. Like, you didn't get. You're still only going to get the person. Yeah, she committed a crime. Okay. You can plan shit. Well, we knew Harley wasn't stupid anyway. So.
What's the point? She's supposed to be crazy. We needed the crazy.
This didn't give us the crazy. Like, take Suicide Squad, Harley Quinn. We didn't get the crazy. And Suicide Squad, Harley Quinn, we got the crazy. But we also knew that she had a certain level of sanity. So, why the fuck didn't we get more of the crazy? Or were you trying to be like, well, y'all get the insane shit all the time. Let's give him something different.
Nobody fucking asked him.
First off, it was different than you was giving us all these coins. Fucking podcasts. So it was supposed to be different. It didn't feel like that. Felt like the episodes were less than unburied, which I'm pretty sure they were. There could have been way more interaction between her and the Joker and this. Yeah, I feel like that was kind of a rush. Like, even then, she doesn't feel like she's still emotionally fucking with the Joker. It's just, you were right, so I'm gonna bust you out. You don't even get the whole chemical thing. Like, there should have been a whole plot of her going to the chemical plant. Now there's these chemicals that killed her father. The Joker throws her in it. There's catharsism and some bullshit. Fucks with her. Pushing her level of sanity. She becomes Harley Quinn when she leaves. Why the fuck not? Why the fuck not? Who do I blame? Do I blame Spotify? Who do I blame DC? I feel like I should be blaming DC. Can't think of too many other motherfuckers that can blame for us. Why? Why couldn't they give us Harley Quinn? They gave us Mag fucking Pie. 3 times. They gave us. You didn't give a Scarface. You gave us the Puppeteer, the Ventriloquist, you know. But I saw the Killer Croc, then the thing at the end, when they're walking through the witch garden and she's purposely fucking with them. Weird to me that she kept coming to fucking her. Like, what was her deal with her? Her goal was she just having fun? What was the goal there? When it comes to the podcast that DC has put out, currently, I'm not a fan over here. Harley Quinn. SoundMind should have been more than what it was. So that's slightly disappointing. Honestly, I'm slightly disappointed. But it was an interesting listen. Should have had a lot more between her and the sessions at Arkham. There was a lot of potential there. They had the potential for her to get revenge on the Wayne Tech, on that Wayne company, the chemical company, with the Joker's help, as kind of a catharsis and a push towards her insanity. Super fucking potential. Why that didn't happen, don't know. Batman had no potential at all. Y'all really couldn't call Winston Duke. Because y'all should have called Winston Duke. I'm just being honest. Like, I'm just saying. Harley Quinn and the Joker opened my eyes. It had potential. Could have been better. I probably, it's like 2.5 stars. Out of 5, it's like 2.5. 2. Yeah.